And welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to Cypress College Basketball on SportsnetUSA.net. Corey Neyland, Mark Pavlovich, Ryan Osborn on camera is Paul Array. Happy to be here on Don Johnson Court for the fourth game of the OEC Conference, OEC, between Riverside and Cypress College. Riverside comes in at 8-7, winning their last three games, 3-0 to start off the conference season, while Cypress is 9-6, and they are 0-3. Rocky start, Mark, to start off the OEC.
Well, when you think of what they did in 16-17, Coach Al Haddock took away that 20-year drought of them not doing much. And Corey, a lot of people thought it was the new Don Johnson era. We were even here too, and we said, boy, we're impressed, a new young coach. Here they go, up and running. Unfortunately for them, they met a team that's in Orange County that's got a hard-nosed coach, just like Coach Al Haddock. His name's Perry Webster. And so things have gone a little around. Of course, we'll see what happens tonight, because I think they're going against a very dynamic Riverside basketball team. Coach Matthews has an attitude. That's what he says to us. I think he teaches old school basketball, and I'll take old school basketball over the new AAU any day of the week.
Well, coming from the Black Tops of Riverside, it is Melvin Walker, 6'1 freshman out of JW North. Zakiah Lovett, the 6'2 freshman from Redondo Union High School. He's the leading scorer for the team. Amir Davis, a 6'3 freshman from Ellison, Texas. Xavier Ford, a 6'3 freshman from Maranatha in Pasadena. And Darius Ware, up front, a 6'5, a sophomore from Deer Valley in Antioch, California. Head coach is Philip Matthews, and he's been coaching, Mark, as long as I've been alive.
Yeah, that's a long, long time.
And for Foolish, and we'll get that just a moment, as Darius Ware and Cameron Barnes, or excuse me, Jalen Slaughter, controls the tap for the Chargers. Chargers, number 32 is Sebastian Castro. He's out of Garden Grove, 6'4", freshman. Number three there is Dimitri Mariolis, 5'7", sophomore from Downey, California. Key greeted over to Cade Flowers at the top of the key, wearing number 52, sets the screen. 21 is Jalen Slaughter, 6'4", freshman from Sarah. And here's Mariolis, dumps down and bucket for Cameron Barnes, the fifth and final starter for the Chargers, 6'4", sophomore from Hesperia. And Riverside, Xavier Ford, nice guard out there, bounce pass. Up and under, blocked out of there by Slaughter as Amir Davis tried to go up and under. Here's Mariolis in the front court. Barnes with the ball. Had a decent game against Fullerton last time we were out on Friday. Mariolis for three, rims out. And Davis with the board, his first.
One of the things you saw in that Fullerton game, Corey, is that Cypress was limited to taking only one shot. They weren't winning the rebound battle. They're going to have to do that against a very talented Tiger team tonight if they want to stay in this game.
And there is Ford again, a step back, no good from the baseline. Rebound, Mariolis controls it, bodies hit the floor. Mariolis has 10 seconds to get across the midcourt stripe as they're moving left to right. I like the yellow unis, Mark.
Well, I knew you would. I like the orange ones myself. They bounce off the court.
Yeah, I love those orange of Riverside with the black lettering and the white numbers. Good defense there by Amir Davis on Castro. Castro, a deep three blocked by Davis.
Melvin Walker takes that out of the air, and the short one starts running it quickly for that Tiger offense.
Team's leading scorer with the ball there is Zakiah Lovett, wearing number four in orange with the top to Ware. Ware to Davis in the corner. Lovett open three. He likes it. So smooth looking tray by Zakiah Lovett. Averaging 15 points a game, or excuse me, 17 points a game as Lovett. Here's Castro. Flowers takes a three. Big man air balls, and that's out of bounds. 3-2, your score.
Sort of shot like Ryan Osborn on that one. Lots of body, looked a little pretty, and came up awfully short for the basket.
Ouch. 3-2, Riverside with the ball and the lead. 17-22 to play in the first half. Ford drives, kicks it all the way out. There's Ford, excuse me, up and under, no good. Castro with the rebound. up to Mariolas. So Cypress in this first three games of the conference season only averaging 20 or only shooting 28% from the field. And Slaughter is fouled on the up. Count the bucket with the continuation. And are they going to get Amir Davis? They do get Amir Davis for his first personal foul. So Jalen Slaughter, 6'4 freshman from Gardena Sierra, as Cade Flowers goes out and Aaron Edison from Crenshaw checks in. Edison, the left-hander, had double figures against Fullerton on Friday.
Only a 40% free thrower as he misses that one. And Corey, you know that drives me crazy.
Yeah, lane violation though. So Darius Ware forgot. So he'll get another one. But you look at the stats, though. If he's a 40% free throw shooter and he shot 100 free throws, that's bad. If he's a 40% free throw shooter and
he shot 10, that's bad.
That's just getting started. He makes the second. He makes the three-point play.
Wow. I'd like to see your credit cards.
I got credit cards. You just don't want to see the bills and the debt. 16:44 to play. 5-3 Cypress with the lead. Reach-in foul, silly foul by Slaughter, his first personal, first team foul.
You watch Cypress with a lot of chasing on defense. Xavier Ford comes out on top, runs the offense normally for the Tigers. Now he goes to the wing. But really, the Cypress defense, Corey, is a lot of hunt and chase out there right now.
And they're in a man-to-man defense. And that means good screens being set by Riverside. No communication on the floor, as that's why they're chasing, as you said, Mark. Around the perimeter to Levette, picked up by Castro in the corner. Five on the shot clock, there's four. Dumps down to A.J. or Melvin Walker, and there's a 30-second shot clock violation. And there's your good defense by Cypress.
Well, and the thing is, Walker put himself in position going down to the wing. He allows the sideline to be an extra defensive player, and every once in a while you need to get away from that sideline and open up the court offensively.
Slaughter checks out. Flowers checks in. So Cade Flowers, Mariolas with the ball. Castro, Barnes there has it poked away, and here's Levette working against Barnes, and he lays it up, lays it in. Five for Zakiya. 5-5 your score. 4 minutes gone by here in the first half of play from Don Johnson Court. There's another steal by Levette, his second. He's coming 2-on-1 against Castro. Euro step in the lane, no bucket but a foul.
Corey, this is a team in Riverside that last game 22 steals against Orange Coast.
30-second timeout, 22?
22.
Ooh, that's a lot for any level as we have a 30-second timeout on the floor, 15:47 to play, knotted up at 5. This is Cypress College basketball on SportsnetUSA.net. And earlier today, not on Sportsnet, but it was a good game. Nonetheless, the women of Cypress beat the women of Riverside 83-80, and might have been the best played basketball game I've seen at the community college level this year, men or women. Big buckets by Priscilla Blanco, who led all players in scoring with 24. Jessica Barrow had 23 for the Chargers. They improved their record to 12-3, and they're 1-0 in conference.
Well, Corey, you want to talk about another game here on SportsnetUSA.net. East L.A. College taking on L.A. Southwest. That one finished up just a few moments ago with Ed Ford and Dan Godino over there.
Did you have a score on it?
I don't yet.
Okay.
Checking on it.
So Levetta at the line. Connects on the first free throw. He's got 6 points. He shoots a little bit better from the line. He's in the 70s, 75.9. We'll give him 76%. After that free throw there, we'll give him 77%. Heck, he made two in a row. We'll give him 80% free throw shooter, Mark. You see how well you shoot?
That's because I'm up here talking about free throws. That's why. They know I like the orange.
7-5 Tigers with the lead. Edison into the ball game is Gage Ivanoff. He's wearing number 33 with the ball. Flowers, Mariolas, and also into the game out of the timeout is Keith Turner, who connects for a three. Nice bucket by Keith Turner out of North Torrance High School, 5'10 freshman. Gives them the lead again, 8-7. Three lead changes thus far, early going, 15-11 to play. Levette again driving, gets to the nice little left box and pushed by Turner.
Well, we know Cypress wants to keep Turner on the floor. He shoots about 42% from three. He just makes that one, so he ups that percentage just a little. Right now we look in this game, still early. Riverside, 2 of 4 on the floor. Cypress, 3 of 6. Not much doing with three-point shots. Cypress has 3 team fouls so far in the game.
Levette, 3 for 3 from the line. 8-8 your score. Levette, Walker, Davis, Ford, and Ware, the 5 on the floor for Riverside. And make it 4 for 4. 9 early points.
Levette's got 6 of those 9.
I got them for all 9.
No, 6. Walker, Melvin Walker's got 3 in the game.
Okay.
Made a 3-point shot.
There we go. That's who made that 3. And there's another 3 by Mariolas, his first of the ball game. Back-to-back trays for Cypress. And they got the lead at 11-9, and there's a hold by Edison.
So far for Riverside, Levette's got 6. Walker's got 3. Davis hasn't scored. Ford hasn't scored. Ware has not taken a shot yet in the game for Riverside.
And that's a chase foul by Edison. Here's Walker, who hit that 3. Dumps it down low through the hands of Ware. Up comes with it is Turner. Turner, 2-on-2, no numbers. He leaves it back. Edison sets up the offense. Good transition defense by the Tigers. Nice, simple jump stop. Old school basketball might have helped there. Flowers for another 3 attempt. He gets that one. Cade Flowers, his first bucket of the game, and it is 14-9 mark. We talked to Coach Matthews for Riverside earlier. He said his team is young, and there's a 3 by Levette, no good. Rebound, Ivanov. 14-9.
And when he says that to Corey, he says it's an attitude of how hard they want to play on the floor.
And on the flip side, Cypress looking for their first victory of the conference season, and they started off strong. They won 6 of their first 7 games as Edison takes a deep 3. And that's money for the left-hander. Aaron Edison out of Crenshaw had a strong game, led all Cypress players in scoring against Fullerton. It's 17-9 in this 8-point lead with 13:33 to play in the first half. Here's Ford around 3-4 peoples and stepped out of bounds. Good defense and on the rotation and help by the Chargers.
So Mariolas, Edison, Turner, Slaughter, Flowers, Barnes, they're all on the board so far. Castro hasn't been there. Ivanov, neither. When you look on the other side for Riverside, Corey, it's been a 2-player show. So Riverside's got to find some more people to get involved in this game offensively, because right now they've only got a couple that can get to the basket. That's Levette and Walker.
Sammy Richardson checks in for Riverside, 6'3 freshman from Lincoln, Nebraska, number 21 on the floor. And also Edwin Collins out of JW North out of Riverside. Here's Edison, already has 1-3. It's a Damon Sullivan back to Edison, working that left side. He's a lefty off the glass, high and 2.
So now we've got 5 points in this game.
Nice block by Ivanov up top. Cypress coming with that defensive intensity that they were lacking against Fullerton on Friday in their last 6 games, I believe. For 7 games, they've won 1. Down low to Ware. Good rotation. Kick out to Walker for his 2nd 3 of the ball game.
So again, it's still Levette, and Walker is the only offense for the Tigers.
Well, those are 2 of the guys who average in double figures for the Tigers. The other is Ford. Step back. Edison feeling it. Rebound by Richardson. Here's Walker. There's Richardson. He traveled. Lifted that pivot foot. And that's a third turnover by the Tigers. And we'll reset that lineup in just a moment. Jalen Slaughter, Aaron Edison, Keith Turner, Gage Ivanov, and Damon Sullivan with the ball. Those are the 5 on the floor for your Chargers. For your Tigers, Ford, Richardson. As there's a flex to the left side for Cypress, back up to Sullivan. Slaughter setting the screens up top. Sullivan doesn't use. 10 on the shot clock. Ivanov likes the 3. long. Here's Amir Davis. A lot of interchangeable parts for the Tigers down low, and there's a poor pass stolen by Edison coming the other way.
Fifth turnover in the game for Riverside.
You got Justin Motley now in the ballgame, wearing number 10. The lanky guy in the orange jersey. Also Kevlin Vance out of Jefferson, Oregon. And there's a big three by Edison. Guys, Aaron Edison. 8 points for Aaron. And it is 22-12. The biggest lead by the Chargers thus far, 11-19 to play first half. Davis resets the offense. Coach Matthews calls out play number two as the Chargers man-to-man defense. Collins down low to Richardson, up and over Sullivan for two.
Nice little pick and roll play on that. He comes up high, sets the screen, rolls off of it, immediately goes to the basket, makes a nice little five-footer.
Mark, you see the difference between Friday and today. You too, Ryan, you were there. And there's an offensive foul. It's going to be on Aaron Edison setting an illegal screen. So 22-14, you're scoring, 10:49 to play. They're setting up their offense. Instead of 18 feet and out, they're scoring up 15 feet and in. And that's why they have an 8-point lead thus far. As Cameron Barnes checks back into the ball game.
And I'm going to throw in my two cents on that too, Ryan. Cypress is starting their offensive quicker than they did against Fullerton.
And Sebastian Castro also. Jalen Slaughter wearing number 21 in yellow. Man-to-man defense. Davis picked up by Sullivan. Up top is Vance. Back rimmed it. Chased down by Barnes. Here's Sullivan slowly in the front court. Drew Alhadif, head coach for the Cypress College Chargers. Weave up top. And here's one of those young, another young coach, Mark, that's big things are going to happen either at this level or the next level. You just know what's going to happen just depending on where. Here's Castro, kick out to Sullivan. Front rimmed it. Vance leading the break. No numbers, so he kicks it out. Three attempts. Back rimmed it. Collins. Ryan Osborn called for a travel. Quickly up to Castro. Back to Sullivan. Set up the offense. 23 to go. 8-point lead for the Chargers. 9:48 to play first half. Keith Turner already has a three. Front rim. The nice tip by Barnes. No good. Davis with the rebound. For Davis, I believe that's rebound number three. Has a block also. Poked away by Castro. Last touch by Richardson. So Mariolas will check back into the ball game for Cypress with Caden Headington out of Edison High School. They join Castro, Slaughter, and Barnes.
And Corey, you were right. Amir Davis has three rebounds in the game right now. He's tied with Cameron Barnes of Cypress, who also has three rebounds in this game so far.
Kai Lovett checks back into the game, as well as Melvin Walker. Xavier Ford, those three are the team's leading scorers. Jared Elliott now from La Sierra. That's also out of Riverside. And staying into the ball game is Justin Motley. Castro working one-on-one, laid up, no good. Yes, it is good. Pooping the harm. Team's leading scorer heads to the line for a three-point opportunity.
So you look at it right now, Riverside shooting 40%. They're 4 of 10. Cypress, 9 of 17 at 52% in this game. So they've been hot. 5 of 11 from three-point country for Riverside, 2 of 5. And, of course, this is only the second time Cypress is going to the charity stripe in this game.
Castro, a teammate of R.J. Nibb over at Fullerton College. And completes the three-point play in high school. They were teammates. He's got 3 points and the team's biggest lead at 11, 25-14, 9:09 to play. And Ryan, me and Mark were talking about Redondo Union High School. It's where Zakiah Levette went. And here's a two-man game on the left side. There is Levette. Did Ian Fox from Fullerton go to Redondo Union? All right.
We were right, huh?
Yes, we were. There's Melvin Walker, back rim to three, high up in the air. For the rebound is Barnes.
Ian Fox went to Redondo Union, went up to Idaho, and then bounced back to Fullerton.
Okay. One of the all-time greats for Fullerton College basketball. We're going to have that all-Fullerton College team later on. Pull up for two, no good by Castro, good D. later on this season for the next game we do for Fullerton, depending on when that is. Headington with the rebound.
So we're going to do a 2025 team?
We might. I already got my list. Mariolas. Running point, double high screen. That's something UCLA like to do. Here's Slaughter. Of course, they could do that with the big men they had. 9 seconds on the shot clock and 11-point lead. Mariolas has 1-3. He takes another three. Long rebound chased down by two Tigers. Here's Walker. 7:45 to play first half. 25-14 is your score. Don Johnson court. Up high in the booth to Levette. Levette headed up by Headington. Nice fake, gets to the lane, puts it up off glass, count the bucket, headed to the line.
And what you got there, Corey, is they call Jalen Slaughter for a foul on that play. He sits there expecting to take the charge. He moves his hips so slightly into the offensive player, and you've got the referee standing behind you. You make that initial move, you're going to get that little bump. They're going to call a block against you every time.
Yeah, Levette did a nice job of keeping his dribble up until the point he could make those two steps. The young kids like to call that a euro. I like to call it, well,
so they call the sidestep. They call the sidestep a euro step is
yes.
What they do?
Yes, they do. They call it the euro step because Sharunas Marshallonis is the inventor of the euro step. And speaking of Sharunas, next time out we'll discuss what we're going to be talking about at halftime. Here's Castro, 25-17 lead. Working on Richardson, good double team by Walker. Here's Mariolas in the lane, high off glass, no good. Tapped around and the carom comes up to Ford. Ford to Walker. Trying to cut into this 8-point lead that Cypress has. Levette thought about the three. Keeps the handles, Ware around the perimeter. Here's Ford, bumped by Flowers. Down low, stolen off that telegraph pass by Castro, and Castro's leading the break, and Riverside is back on D.
13th turnover for Riverside in this game.
Already?
Yes.
Freshman team, young team. Coach Matthews was talking about that earlier, and almost a steal by Levette. He's got two. Turner chases it down. 13 to shoot. In the corner. On the wing is Flowers. A big man likes to three. Rim doesn't like him. He's 1-for-3. 6:28 to play. Walker to Ware. Baseline jumper. Shot it long, but it got that back rim. And that's what you call a shooter's touch, guys.
That's Darius Ware's first basket of tonight's game.
6'5", 205 out of Deer Valley. Barnes. Looking down low to Turner. Good front by Richardson. Mariolas on the screen by Flowers. Free throw line. Flowers drives, lays it up with English, too much. 25-19, your score, almost a steal by Castro on a force by Ford. And an eventual steal by the Chargers, and here coming the other way.
And Ryan Castro beats the offensive player to the spot, and that's what causes that turnover.
Ford got away with a walk and a travel and a run. Castro with a deep three. That's good by Sebastian. So Sebastian Castro has 6 points, and there's a 30-second timeout taken. Here at 5:25 to play, 28-19. Cypress in control in this first half of play. We were talking about...
Hey, wait a minute. You know, I just have to give a little shout-out because, you know, yesterday was Orthodox Christmas.
And that's and what I was about to
say. And to my man up in Sacramento, now the general manager, maybe one of the best European players of all time and a fellow Serb of mine. I'm sure he smoking a cigar yesterday, championship rings, probably looking at him when he was with the Lakers. Vladi Divac is on that list. He probably looked at the list yesterday and said, you know, I should be ranked in the top, maybe ranked in the top 10. So I don't know. You two guys who are non-Europeans may want to tell me what you think about the greatest European players in the NBA at halftime.
So what we're going to do at halftime is talk about those European players. Since it's Serbian Christmas, that was yesterday, right?
It was, yeah.
Yesterday.
Orthodox Christmas, yeah. Yes.
Orthodox Christmas, and since Mark Pavlovich is Serbian, we decided out of the timeout is 28-19, 5:15 to play first half. Love it. Pulls up for three off the screen by Ware. and you see the freshman doing big things.
Double digits in this game. He's at 12 right now.
28-22 is your score. Castro, Ivanov, Mariolis, Barnes, and for the first time, number 45, Devion Smith-Coleman, 6'4", center from Artesia High School. As Barnes drives left baseline, there's a reach-in foul on Lovett. Picks up his first personal. He's joined on the court by Richardson, Ware, Davis, and Collins. So we're going to talk about the best European basketball players ever. And there's a couple categories we're going to break it down into. The best European players, but we're going to focus on best European players that came over to America and played in the NBA in college. But we will get some for European only, but we'll focus on the American thing since that's where we're here. And there's a short three by Castro, strong rebound by Richardson. Collins working. Back to Richardson. Davis around the perimeter to Lovett. Lovett with the left-handed dribble. Barnes might be the team's best defender for the Chargers. He's on the team's best scorer for Riverside. Down low on the Richardson on the slip screen. Good recovery by Castro. In the corner with seven to shoot. Here's Collins. Settles for a three. In and out. Rebound Barnes. Good defensive set by the Chargers. They're up by six, 28-22. Their biggest lead has been 11.
And you look at them so far, Corey, they've already got 11 deep in this game in the first half alone for the Coach Alhada.
And there's a hold by Ware. Big, strong body by Smith-Coleman creates that foul. That's the fourth team foul. So no shots yet from the charity stripe as Cade Flowers in for Devian Smith-Coleman.
You look at Cypress so far, they've got 14 points off of turnovers in this game. I would think that rebound would be won by Cypress. But it's the Tigers right now that are winning the rebound battle out there, Corey. And it doesn't look like that when you look at the naked eye out here watching the game tonight.
Scrappy team. Both teams are very, very scrappy. No team with that dominant big man who's listed at 6'10", like a lot of the schools have. Two of the schools that do have them are Fullerton and Santiago Canyon, who lead the way in the Orange Empire Conference. In the lane is Collins, throws one up. We're going to call that a pass to Ware. Ware misses the tip. Barnes with the rebound, his third.
He is in the Christmas mood for Serbian Christmas.
He's feeling very generous today, giving gifts all over.
Yes, I am.
Probably could get a free dinner from him after the game.
I drop knowledge, son. And here's Barnes working one-on-one against Davis. Great defense by Amir Davis, and he saves it right to Barnes. Blocked by Richardson, jumped the ball up. An alternating arrow is going to belong to the Tigers.
So, again, when you look at the Tigers, Lovett's got 12, Walker's got 6, Richardson with 2, Ware with 2, and Corey, that is the scoring for this Riverside basketball team.
Well, that's the way it's been all season.
You need more.
At this level? No, you don't.
Okay.
If you got three guys who can get you 15 points a game, that's good. The rest of the guys can get you 6 points a game. That's your secondary, that auxiliary unit that can keep you in win ball games. Here's a three by Lovett. No good on a three as he heads down to the ground. And Mariola steps out of bounds as he was battling Ware underneath, 28-22 with 2:32 to play. It would be nice if you had more.
And take the 2017 state championship, for example. San Diego City only had one guy. That was Wonder Smith. Then when you look at Fullerton College, they had Reese, they had Fox. That was it. Both of those two teams just needed one or two scorers.
And the rest to play those roles.
But you're talking real scorers, guys. You're talking guys that are in the 20s.
No. Fox only averages 16 points, if that. And there's a nice floater from the baseline.
And Reese was averaging 15.2.
By Kevlin Vance. It's just everybody else has to know their role. And those teams, San Diego City and Fullerton, they knew their role and what they had to do. Barnes drives again, forces up a tough shot for the second time and misses again. Amir Davis gets the rebound and leads the break. He's joined by Richardson, off glass, no good, bad angle. And there's another turnover. It's gotten a little bit sloppy here with 1:45 to play in the first half in a four-point game.
And let me just counter by saying, you talk about a Fullerton team that played outrageous defense and another team that played outrageous defense. So, yeah, maybe you might have had two scorers, but you had defenses that were smothering against their opponents. And then you can get away with your sort of thinking. If you don't, please.
You
can't give gifts away and not have any money in the bank.
No, you need a strong defense. That's for anybody. If you have five players averaging 10 points a ball game, you have seven players averaging 10 points a ball game, that's fine. You got no defense, you ain't winning. You have two players averaging 15 points a ball game, but the rest playing their role.
And
you
a strong
no,
defense.
No, listen, and you have a strong defense, you're winning. In both scenarios, you have to have a strong defense.
And when you talk about it, you look at Riverside, they are not that sort of defensive team.
No, they're not.
So they need to have more offense because they don't have it on the defensive side.
They have more offense. They have enough offense. They need a defense, and they need consistency. Offense is not where it's at. It's the defensive side of the ball and that blacktop asphalt attitude that they need.
Yeah.
1:29 to play in the first half. They're down by four. They got the ball. Here's Vance, who has a bucket. There's Walker, who has a three. Ware giving him the screen up top. Flowers hedges in the corner of Davis, lays it up left-handed, missed it, and the rebound goes to Flowers. He tried to be cute and got it put back off that front rim.
And we'll recreate Anthony Davis going up high for a ball and come down on his back just a second. Corey's going to be my actor.
First off, you got the statement wrong. I can't jump. Not anymore. Here's Castro, pull up for two, back rim. Here's Vance again. 49 seconds to play. In the front court, Vance wanted the screen. He gets one, uses that left-handed dribble. Ware did a nice job of rolling back down to the right block, couldn't be delivered. Here's Levesque. There's the delivery on the left block. Kick out, open three. Walker back rim, chase down. Ware kicks it back out to Levesque. We've got 27 seconds to shoot. 30 on the shot clock. Nope, shot clock is turned off because it's under 30. Down by four, saving for the last shot. Melvin Walker out of Riverside, JW North High School. Wants it on the left side, picked up by Castro. Double high with seven. There's five. Davis, free throw line, corner. Vance wanted the three he called for 30 seconds ago and buries it. And that'll end the half. He's got 5 points, and Cypress has a one-point lead, 28-27. This is Cypress College Basketball on SportsnetUSA.net with Corey Neyland, Mark Pavlovich, Ryan Osborn up in the booth, Paul Array on the camera as we sit here at Don Johnson Court. And just to recap, the first game that we saw here in Don Johnson Court, Cypress women win 83-80. It was a great game against Riverside. For Riverside, Trinity Vasquez had 19.7 rebounds and 5 assists. Regina's Gates had 21 points, 5 and 5. And Ariane Madlambayan, 9 points. And Mark will like this, 16 rebounds.
I like that.
And Riverside did a nice job. They shot, 39%? They played well.
What did they shoot from the free throw line?
They shot from the free throw line, 63% from the free throw line for the game. Fullerton shot 52% from the line.
Who?
I'm sorry, Cypress shot 52% from the line, 42% from the field, and 31% from three. We had two players in double figures. Huh. Only two players in double figures. Huh. 23 points for Jessica Barrow, 24 points for Priscilla Blanco, and they won the game with only two players in double figures. How does that happen?
Which team are we talking about? Because you mentioned Fullerton, Cypress, and Riverside. There were three teams on the court?
Sure, but only two of them was in double figures.
Okay. Ryan, we had other games going on tonight, too. So what are some of the other games around the area?
Well, let's start with another game that was here on SportsnetUSA.net. East L.A. and L.A. Southwest. That's actually very late in the second half over at East L.A. It's 75-61, the East L.A. Huskies with the lead over there. As we go towards the top of the schedule, it's Fullerton College taking on Golden West. 86-61 the final as Fullerton improves to 15-0 this season, 4-0 in conference. Golden West now 2-14 and 0-4 in their own conference. San Diego Mesa with a 9-point victory, 70-61 over Cuyamaca College. Pronounced that correctly according to what we learned at the Don Johnson Classic 4 years ago. Cuyamaca is the correct way to pronounce that.
Not Cuyamacas.
I bought a pair of those, as a matter of fact. They're really nice.
L.A. Harbor beat Pasadena City by a final score of 72-71 as that one went down to the wire. And Saddleback and Orange Coast, 93-52. Saddleback improves to 10-6.
You know, we talk about Don Johnson. We've said it's a stadium. When you think about Don Johnson here, was a consensus All-American and an All-Conference honoree when he was a senior and coached by John Wooden when he was at UCLA in 1952. When he left UCLA, he became a coach here at Cypress College and was here for years. Won 2 state titles, 7 conference titles, and when he retired here from Cypress, he was, when he retired, the most winning coach in community college basketball. 588 wins, 259 losses. Corey, now he just passed away a year ago in February. He's now 4th on the all-time list. One of the nicest guys. We had the pleasure to meet him, all 3 of us, when we did the classic, went over to meet him. And another guy, you know, it's fun meeting the older basketball coaches like we did with Coach Matthews here at Riverside. They talk the old school basketball. I mean, it's hard nosed, it's asphalt basketball, it's getting jolted by a screen, and it's sort of fun talking to the coaches that have been around for a while. We'll see what Coach Al Hadaf, if at the end of his career when he's in his 80s, if he's got as many wins as Don Johnson had.
You know, if he stays at Cypress, I think he will. I think he's the type of coach who will build a program and get them to where they need to be. Cypress has a history of winning. 77, they won a title. 1980, they won a title. Arguably, you have 3 of the better big men in community college history, especially in the state of California, with Eric Pauley is one of them, Swin Nader, Mark Eaton. Those 2 of them went to the NBA. Long careers in the NBA. So it's one of those things where you build. Derek Franklin was one of those guys who played early 2000s who was pretty good, but who was pretty good also, Euro players. Euro players, they've enhanced the quality of the basketball life, if you will, here in the United States. And we had a list since it was Serbian Christmas yesterday. We wanted to get involved in saying the best players from Europe that play basketball. Now, you break it down, guys, and we focus on guys who played in the USA, NBA, college basketball. That's where our focus is. So we're going to leave out, and not by omission, we're going to leave them out just because they're just Europe. So mainly in Europe, you guys got Nikos Galis, Dimitris Diamantidis, Radivoj Korac, Sergei Belov. Okay, there's one. So you know Sergei Belov, 1972 gold medal winners, and Dejan Bodiroga. Players like that. Who excelled in Europe, no matter if they're in Russia, where they're Spain, whatever. That's where that's where they excelled in. Kresimir Kosic, you get that one from Croatia? No? Oh, okay, go and stare up your list. So we're going to focus on the guys who really came over to American Enhance, and we're going to give your top 3.
In other words, like Nikola Vucevic that came, he could be put in that category?
He could be put in that category. So, Ryan, I'll let you start since I'm taking all yours already. I'll let you start.
You got one left?
No, I've still got some. So I will start off with, I'll say Pau Gasol is in my top 3. Dirk Nowitzki as well is also in my top 3. And for now, I like Tony Kukoc.
Okay.
Now, Giannis has a chance to get into my top 3, but he's got to keep going in the NBA. He's dynamic. He's an MVP, but he's got to do more.
Okay. I feel you there. They don't make my top 3. Pau Gasol does not make my top 3. If I had to make a top 3 right now, today, I would probably agree with the list that I saw online that had Arvydas Sabonis out of Lithuania. You know, me and Mark had conversations about Arvydas. If he came when he was young and healthy, we're not talking about the Bulls dynasty winning 3-3. Portland would have won at least one of those championships, probably 2. Drazen Petrovic is gone.
Love those Croatians.
Way too soon. And Dirk Nowitzki. Those would have to be my top three. I wanted to disagree with the list that I saw online, those lists, but those would have to be my top three of all time for what they did. Dirk, best all time, based on what he's done coming from Europe over to the U.S.
Well, I tell you, it probably doesn't belong on your top three list, but I've always appreciated what Marc Gasol has done as a player and who he has played for, the teams. He hasn't played with quality players all the time, but you saw what happened when he was in Toronto.
Yeah, he did.
He was a role player. He was a role player in Toronto, and because when he went to Toronto, that's why they won the world championship. Forget you two guys up here. You guys are just so biased, it's ridiculous. And I'll take Luka Doncic, who's just coming into it. But I tell you what, I've watched this kid play. I get amazed with watching him right now. I think at the end of his career, and I know it's young, you'll look at me, Corey, because I know you know the game, and Ryan knows the game. I think both of you guys will look at me in 3 years and say, Mark, you don't have to wait much longer.
Yeah.
He's a player that's going to be one of the top European players of all time.
Yeah, if his career goes like it should be, he'll be the best European player over to America of all time, including Giannis, because Giannis will be number two of all time.
And when you look at Luka, it's also impressive considering the fact the time that he spent over at Real Madrid, he was one of their top three players possibly all time.
Yeah.
Definitely single season, but possibly all time as a 17-year-old.
Oh, yeah. It's like he was like Ricky Rubio when he started at 15. He's on the list as one of the all-time greats because of what he did in Europe. And he's had a solid career. But Luka, if all goes well, he'll be the greatest of all time. And actually, I won't put Giannis there. It would still be Dirk.
So I got to ask you both a question, because one of Corey's favorite teams has one of the guys I have on the list. And yet, I really have mixed emotions about looking at Tony Parker.
Why?
I mean, was he... Would he go in the top five great of Europeans?
Yes, Tony
Parker
is
great. But
I
look at the teams they play on, too. I mean, there's those guys that you say, okay, look what they're surrounded with, which makes them even better players. And, I mean, Corey, when you look at Tony Parker, look at who he was surrounded by in his career. You've got somebody
yeah.
that you played next to that you say could be, in your mind, and maybe is.
That's every great team. Look who he's surrounded by. James Worthy, look who he was surrounded by. He's still considered great. Scottie Pippen is considered great.
Those guys played in Europe? I didn't know that.
Tony Kukoc, look who he's surrounded by. But you realize, first part of the season when Scottie Pippen was hurt, he led that team. Tony Parker is there. Vlade Divac is there. Your guy, Detlef Schrempf. Hey, if Kyle Kuzma from the Lakers can be more Detlef Schrempf, he'll be a Laker for life.
Well, and see, I also want to go to someone who perhaps was, we'll say, more underrated simply because he played on the same team as Reggie Miller. But I think that when you look at Rick Smits, he's one of the guys that I look at kind of like a Marc Gasol that you can look at and say, this was a big man that if he played in an L.A. market, if he played in a New York market, people would be buying his jerseys all over the place.
Yeah, but would you consider Rick Smits a true European guy coming over or just because he was born there? And most of the time he played in the U.S.
I would, because when he was trained – his family trained him when he was little to play more of a European basketball type of game that emphasized mobility for a big person, that emphasized passing outside of the post. So, yes, I would still give him that nod.
Okay.
So where did you put Peja Stojakovic?
On my almost list with Rick Smits,
okay,
Marc Gasol,
because I didn't hear you mention
Goran
I was going to ask
Nikola
you.
Jokic, Juan Carlos Navarro.
So why in your almost list?
Andre Kirilenko and Hedo Turkoglu.
Why on your almost list?
Because they're almost top five, almost. Peja is probably the best, second best shooter out of all of them. Drazen Petrović is the best shooter. But Peja can shoot the lights out. He's one of those guys who, yeah, I'll take him. But he doesn't make that top tier list. He's just almost made it.
And, you know, if you want to talk about mobility and also shooting as well, Predrag Danilović was also very good down with Miami.
Yeah. Yeah, he was. So he was
a good
player. These guys
are all Serbians. This is nice.
Well, you talk about Serbian. I'll take the Yugoslavian national team from the late 80s, early 90s. Your team consisted of Dino Raja, who we didn't mention. Okay. Drazen Petrović. Tony Kukoc. And Vlade Divac. All four of those guys were on the national team from the late 80s to early 90s. They ruled Europe for a play before Spain with the Gasol brothers. Rubio, Rudy Fernandez, and Juan Carlos. Before those guys, it was Yugoslavia with those teams. And that's really another team that brought the forefront, along with, we mentioned, Sharulis Marshalonis in Lithuania. If you ever get a chance to check out that their documentary, fun documentary about the Lithuanian national team, one of those guys who really brought European basketball to the forefront.
Okay, so then is this young guy that's in the league now, is he going to be on one of your almost list as his career goes along when you're looking for Zingas, when he plays the game? Because he hasn't really, I don't think he's lived up to what people thought he would be. So Corey's got an almost list for European. We got Doncic. You guys have already said, yeah, superstar. He'll be there. What about Porzingis?
When you look at Kristaps coming out of Europe, only the Knicks had him rated very high. Okay, he wasn't really expected to be someone sensational, someone great. Then all of a sudden, his first 3 years in New York, he was very good. He was one of the better European players in all of the NBA, but with the injuries, but moving to another team that has other scorers, that turns him into that second or maybe even third option on offense. I think he's lived up to exactly where he was projected prior to his draft.
I'll ask you even better. Who are you going to take off for Kristaps Porzingis?
Who am I going to do what?
Who are you going to take off for? Who would you rather have other than for Kristaps Porzingis?
Well, I'll take Porzingis right now.
Over who?
Oh, you mean over my whole list right now?
Who are you going to take him over?
Oh, I can't take him off of my list because I got nothing but champagne on here.
Yeah, there's not one you would take him over.
No, not right now. Not for me, no.
Yeah. And okay. There's a guy who...
He's still growing. He's still progressing.
Oh, yeah.
He's
got a chance to be one of the greats, but right now he needs to be that guy.
If you want to talk about a person who kind of was projected to be a lot more than he ended up being in the NBA, I think you also have to look at a guy like Joakim Noah out of Florida. When he comes into the NBA, born in France, also raised kind of in a more Euro basketball type of mentality, very scrappy, comes out of Florida as a national champion, goes into the NBA. His first 5 years in the NBA, he was a very defensively dynamic person
Chicago. He was a good player first 5 years in the NBA. Speaking first of all, 28-27, we're at halftime here at Cypress and Riverside at Cypress College on SportsnetUSA.net. Sorry to interrupt.
No, you're fine. It's when you look at Joakim Noah, I think that he had the opportunity to be one of those better defensive players in Euro history. Opportunity, not that he was, but if you kept those first 5 years going into the 12 years that he would have been playing right now, if he progresses the same way, he's not Marc Gasol.
No,
he's still defensively very good.
Yeah, defensively very good, but he don't even sniff this.
No.
Well, when we look at the score right now for these two teams, RC Riverside, Labette's the leading scorer with 12, followed by Walker, Vance, and Richardson in the game so far here today. When you look at the Cypress side, Corey, it's been Aaron Edison with 8 points, followed by Sebastian Castro with 6, then 3-3-3-3-3. That's Marzolis, Turner, Slaughter, Flowers, Barnes all on the board. When you look at that turnovers, well, Riverside leads the way on this. You look at Riverside, 9 of 24 from the floor. Cypress, 10 of 27 from the floor, and that's why we've got a one-point game.
And how many did you say Levette had?
Levette has in this game right now
12.
12 points. 3 of 5 from the floor, 5 of 5 from the free throw line.
On the floor to start the second half, Castro, one bounce to the left, front rims it, rebound Amir Davis. Riverside in orange with the ball moving down. He has it in the corner to Ford. Ford steps into a three and nails it, and they've got their lead.
Ford's first basket. Davis right now leads everybody with 5 rebounds on the floor.
And we'll reset. Castro with the ball. Barnes, Slaughter. Mariolas now with the ball, and Flowers to start us for the second half for the Chargers. Here is Barnes. Gets in the way. Castro leaves it for Mariolas. He's got 1-3. Make it 2 threes. He's got 9 points, make it 10 points.
Riverside lost everybody defensively on that play, and it looked like a pickup game on asphalt.
Ford with the ball, Levette back to Ford. Ware wanted to set a screen, double team at the right block. He gets away with a travel. There's a jump ball. He does not get away with that travel, and it's a turnover. That's number what, 15, 16, 20?
15.
15th turnover for the Tigers. So with Davis, Ford, Walker, Levette, and Ware, Those are the five players on defense. 18:57 to play in the game, 31-30 Cypress.
And Cypress has 14 points right now, Corey, on turnovers alone.
Here's Castro behind the back dribble, almost stolen. Recovered by Barnes. Flowers hit 1-3 in the first half, drives right baseline, kick out to Mariolas. Back to Flowers. Bulls his way, or running one-handed. And I was going to say, do you remember Dick Barnett?
I do.
Well, I saw shades just now. 33-30 is your score. Charged with the lead, countering is Levette. Too soft, Ware up, fouled, no. They get the foul from behind by Cade Flowers, and that'll bring Darius Ware to the line.
Cade Flowers has 5 points in this game, one rebound so far in this game. So like we said, Aaron Edison's got 8 points. Levette, the leading scorer for Riverside, with 12 points in this game.
Ware connects on the first. He's got three. 33-31 your score, 18-13 to play. Head coach for Riverside is Philip Matthews, and connects on a second as well. He's got 4 points. 6'5 sophomore does. Drew Alheda, the head coach for Cypress. Castro dumps down. Barnes gets away from Ford, up and under. No. Got to finish those once you got them. Here's Walker quickly in the front court. A trailing Ware puts it in the lane. No. Jump ball. Alternating arrow is going to stay with the Tigers. 33-32, Riverside has the ball and down by one. Walker will inbound on the baseline. Davis at the three-point line. Looking to go down to Levette as Slaughter slips. 20 on the shot clock. Levette to Davis around the perimeter. Ford with the baseline jumper, short rims it, and here's Barnes. Is that rebound number 5 for Barnes?
Barnes now has 8 rebounds in the game.
8 rebounds for Cameron Barnes. Doing a nice job on the interior for the Chargers. Mariola's free throw line jumper is short. Here's Ford the other way with the left-handed dribble. Good transition D by the Chargers. And here's Walker again with the left side. A lot of dribbling marked with no direction. No direction, that's correct. Dribbling just for the sake of dribbling. Davis in the air. Ford sets his feet. We're going to call that a pass, too, because it missed so badly. And there's a foul because he missed so badly on Castro.
And I want to ask you about that. Does it not look like, and Ryan, if you can see it, too, it looks like Riverside is trying to guide the basket. Corey, you know when guys like to make pretty shots? Is that what's happening on the floor here with this Riverside shooting team?
No, they just haven't shot the ball that well this season from the three-point line. So instead of just shooting, you see the guide. Ford was there. He was wide open, and he was so wide open he had time to think. And he had time to think that I'm so wide open that I need to make this shot. And then he thought some more that I need to make this shot, so I got to be perfect.
Almost like setting up camera equipment, huh?
Yes, indeed.
And that's why it was an air ball. That's why Castro picked up the foul. He wasn't ready for that. Davis at the line for two.
Don't you love it? Everybody in the booth thinks they have a microphone on. Isn't that something?
Aaron Edison checks in with 8 points in the first half. Out comes Cade Flowers.
We'll bring a fourth one next time. Ryan looks and says, what did we just step on? As long as it's not this.
Amir Davis averages 4 points in conference play.
As long as it doesn't belong to Ed Ford.
Or excuse me, 4 points for the season as he makes the first free throw. Tying the game up at 33. He shoots 56% from the charity stripe, but he makes the first. He's got 4 points, make it 5 points. And a 1 point lead for Riverside. I believe there are 4 lead changes thus far in this game with 16:47 to play. Mariola's working up top. Free throw line extended. On that right side is Ivanov. Gets caught in the air to Edison. Edison in the air. And throws it away, last touch by Levette.
And you like Levette, who anticipates the pass on the ball and takes off the alley, blocks the alleyway. Corey Hilmes comes away with a steal.
And here's Mariola's pull-up three. That clanked off backboard. And Davis the other way. Bounce pass, pretty to Ware, and a foul by Ivanov. That was a nice fast break. They didn't have the numbers, but he wrapped around Davis, looking not spry as Ware gets the bucket.
And every once in a while you'll see it nowadays that too many young people, Corey, do not use that sort of path. You called it a bounce pass. That was just right there. They take the right angle so the person who receives it gets it when it's coming up and continues the layup without adding an extra bounce or step to the basket.
Ware cannot convert the three-point play the old-fashioned way, but they do have their biggest lead of the game at 36-33, 16-16 to play. Danger zone for Cypress as Edison in and out with a three. Four. Walker. As you see the pep in the step by not the Tigers now. Davis off the glass, no good. Barnes with his ninth rebound. Loose ball foul by Darius Ware, who can't believe he got called a foul for a foul by grabbing somebody's arm.
And now the Tigers are enforcing the backboard game. They've got 27 rebounds in this game compared to Cypress altogether. Cypress only has two offensive rebounds in the entire game today.
Keith Turner, who hit a three in the first half, checks into the ballgame for the Chargers with Mariolas with the ball, trying to drive on Walker in the corner to Turner. Pull up from 17. Nice use of the glass. 36-35 Tigers. With the lead. Ford around the perimeter in the corner to Davis. Good defense and close out by the Chargers. Up top is Ivanov, working against Walker. Open is Davis. Davis drives the lane, puts it up with the left hand. No, but he's fouled. And he'll head back to the line for two.
Now Davis has 2 points. And as he heads the line, well, what he should be doing is heading to Miller Toyota of Anaheim. He said, it's Serbian Christmas. You know what I need to do? I need to go buy Mark a brand new Toyota, Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Miller Toyota of Anaheim is a proud sponsor of community college sports, high school sports, but most of all, education. That's Miller Toyota of Anaheim.
Davis hit his last two, misses his next one. He's got 5 points.
Now, they've got him officially only with 2 points in this game, Corey, and I'm sort of like you. I thought he had more points than that.
Well, he stays on 2 points because he misses both free throws, and you see why he's a 50% free throw shooter on the season. 36-35. Tigers with the lead. Chargers with the ball. Chargers not with the ball because that is a turnover.
Man, I still hope you get me that Toyota, though. I like it.
We'll reset these lineups in just a moment. 5 minutes gone by in the second half, and it's 36-35 with the Tigers. Walker with the ball. Davis, Ford, Levette, and Justin Motley. Man-to-man defense. Chargers been that the whole way. Drives baseline, blocked by Barnes. And last touch by Levette, who didn't reset himself in bounds. So that is a turnover coming the other way.
Corey, you look at this game right now. Riverside shooting 35% from the floor. Cypress, 37%. From three-point country, Riverside, 35%. Cypress, 38%. From the floor. Cypress has only gone to the charity stripe twice in this game.
Castro with a nice dribble drive and gets fouled. Take your pick, Mobley or Davis. A little hesitation dribble at the three-point line as he'll head to the charity stripe for two free throws. Try to tie and take the lead. Castro came into this game as the team's leading scorer. Cypress is 0-3 with Golden West in the conference for the first three games, and he makes the first. Got 6 points as Amir Davis and Xavier Ford check out. Into the ball game is Kelvin Vance and Sammy Richardson. 37-36 your score. Fifth lead change of the game. Walker into the front court. 14-34 to play. Orange Coast is 0-2 along with Santa Ana 0-2 in conference play. Just beginning conference play in the OEC. Down low, Mobley brings it out to Vance, into the half on a three and makes a turnover there. That's turnover number 17. Back the other way is Castro, feeling it. Free throw line jumper, Barnes back rimmed it. Moldy with the rebound. Walker, head up, four court. Richardson on the screen. Moldy flash across the middle, no go. Kelvin Vance steps into a three and back rimmed it. And here's Barnes with the leak out, puts it up and lays it off the bottom of the rim. And here comes Riverside the other way. 37-36, they're down by one. And man-to-man defense as they miss Moldy again, curling to the basket. Well, Lovett says, that's okay, I'll make this two. 38-37. 13-18 to play. He's got 14 points.
Right now, Riverside needs to get 28 more points to hit the number Corey Neyland said they would score.
Here's Barnes for three. He clanks off front iron. 13 minutes to play. And driving the lane, a reach in by Barnes, that is Edison, or bodied up by Mariolas. Take your pick. That's the fifth team foul for the Chargers as Amir Davis checks back in with Edwin Collins. Out goes Walker and Lovett. Timeout taken with 12:58 on the floor. Riverside 38-37 lead over the Chargers. This is Cypress College basketball on SportsnetUSA.net.
So like we were saying, well, you know, it's that time of year. It was Serbian Christmas yesterday. Christmas just ended, and you know what's right around the corner with the best deals you can get on an automobile? That's at Miller Toyota of Anaheim. That's right. Go down to Euclid and the 91. Walk in there and say, hey, Corey, Mark, Ryan, they sent me from sportsnetusa.net and said, you guys have the best deals. You want that new Toyota? You'll get a deal on it. Maybe that used Toyota. One that you want to give to your son or daughter that are getting ready to graduate from a community college and heading to that NAIA school or that Division I, II, or III university. Where should they get that car? Well, Miller Toyota of Anaheim. So take a little time out, peruse the parking lot, find that car that Corey, Ryan, or I might buy, and say, hey, what sort of deal can I get on this car here at Miller Toyota? At the end of the day, you'll walk away saying sportsnetusa.net. You knew exactly what you were talking about. Maybe not when it came to basketball, but about buying cars for Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Miller Toyota of Anaheim, located at Euclid in the 91, is a proud sponsor of community college sports, high school sports, but most of all, education. That's Miller Toyota of Anaheim. And you know, I bet you Gabby Neyland is out there right now buying a new Toyota for you guys. Corey's going, I hope not, because it's going to be one expensive car.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Out of the timeout, 12:58 to play, 38-37, Riverside with the ball. Richardson on the inbound to Davis with Vance, Moldy, and Collins. Davis has the ball, calling out directions. He says, Collins, come on over. Edwin does. Richardson, they missed the slip screen three straight times now. And that slip screen is when they set up the high pick. And the big man rolls to the basket, and there's a three to beat the buzzer by Edwin Collins, his first bucket of the game out of J.D. Dorff W. North High School, and that's their biggest lead of four, 41-37. Eulo Howard in the ball game now for the Chargers, wearing number four, Barnes, baseline. Mariola steps into a three, in and out, no good, put back by Barnes. Barnes with his fourth point, and he'll head to the line, and he was fouled on the putback.
And Corey, you like the type of young man like him that works. That's his 12th rebound of today's game going to the basket.
Hesperia High School, 6'4 sophomore.
The high desert.
And he was pretty high that time on the putback. He thought he wanted to put back two-handed dunk, but because of the foul, he'll head to the line and try to convert to three-point play. 41-39 is your score. That's the third team foul in the second half, and he does. So Barnes now with 5 points, 12 rebounds, and Cypress down by one. Davis working around high screens at the top of the key. On the wing now, hands to Vance. Vance with the right-handed dribble. Thought about a three. Skip pass out. Pull up Collins for two. Edwin Collins, the last 5 points for the Tigers. Extend the lead to three at 43-40. And here's Barnes again at the free throw line, right side. Howard out of Savannah High School in the corner to Barnes. Thought about it. Romulo has it snapped back. And had a flashback of Fullerton College volleyball as Amir Davis slaps it out of bounds. 11:30 to play.
Samaria Longstreet doing the work.
There you go. Cypress College, they got a pretty fair volleyball team as well. Howard with 8 seconds, 7 seconds. Mariolas dumps down low to Castro against Richardson and scores off the backboard, 43-42. And quickly in the front court, but good transition.
Castro now in double figures in this game for Cypress.
And watch the 4-set mark. They're going to flex on the outside. They're going to get a down screen from Ware. And again, it's missed. Here's Davis. Skip pass. Collins, three in a row. No good. Back rim. And here's Barnes with rebound number 13. Ahead of the pack is Howard. He's working one with Richardson. Nice defense by Sammy Richardson. Poked it out of bounds, and he touched it last.
Curry, when you talk about the slip screen, is it because somebody doesn't see it or they're just late with the pass?
Yes.
Okay. Ryan's not quite sure.
It's the fundamentals of when you come up to the top of the key, you always got to make sure you're not facing the opposite basket, but you're halfway facing your basket, and the man is there so you can put it up over a nice little bounce pass as Castro misses a three. But there's Jalen Slaughter with the putback, and he's fouled.
Well, and Corey, you always look at what coaches talk about with that triple threat type of stance. When you're coming off of the screen, especially up high, you have to be able to, like you mentioned, kind of position yourself with your shoulders towards the basket, or at least in rhythm towards the basket, because if not, then not only are you facing away from the basket, you're shooting across your body, almost like a pitcher in baseball, more like a Jared Weaver for those here in Orange County, pitching across your body. It's like shooting across your body. You don't have the accuracy.
Now Slaughter connects on the first free throw. That's his fourth point. Looking to give him the lead with 10:28 to play in the game. 43-43 is your score. Slaughter, the right-hander. Back rimmed it. Darius Ware with the rebound. Will reset as four is now back in the ball game. Number 13, four now has it. That's Lovette. Two is Walker. He gets it gloved by Slaughter, and here comes Mariolas who trips, but luckily there's Barnes. One-on-one, laid it up and laid it in. He's got 7 points and 13 rebounds. 45-43, Cypress with the lead. Under 10 minutes to play, and there is a timeout on the floor.
So they're going to polish the boat right now.
You've seen two magnificent blocks on the perimeter already today. Davis on one side and Slaughter on the other side for Cypress.
Well, they see where the apex of the ball is going to be, so they reach that highest point. They're not playing the body of the opponent. They're actually playing where the reach of the ball is. That's where mathematics come in basketball.
But even more importantly, when in the last 10 years have you really seen a team, other than Fullerton lately, that closes out that well in the perimeter? Normally what you see is guys who just kind of half attempt out towards the three-point line. Instead, these guys are closing out as quickly as possible once the ball gets there.
Yeah, San Francisco does that pretty well. And here's my old man get off my lawn moment. A nice little jump stop from 15 feet away would have prevented all that. And there's a miss, but a putback by Darius Ware.
Wait a minute, was that excuse me?
Doesn't matter. 45-45, and there's a blow-by by Howard, and he connects for two. 47-45, 9:22 to play. Davis, and there it is. And it has something to do also with the hedging by Cypress. Because they're hedging so forcefully, they're not allowed to, and they're preventing that pass down low. No, I'm sorry. That's just bad offense because they had that Ware wide open underneath. And here's Levette with the left hand. He is a talented offensive weapon. 47-47.
Ron, I'm going to go back to you, though. Like Corey was talking about this twice now. They've had the slip screen. I think it's over-dribbling, and the refusal by a lot of these young players to give up the basketball as quickly as you need to play a team game. Yes? No?
Yeah, I think I would agree with you, Mark, because when you look at Riverside, every time they come past the timeline, you're always seeing them pick one spot on the floor that they're going to, and that's where the ball stays until it absolutely has to get swung around, and it's causing problems. As you mentioned, normally what you would like to see in a free-flowing offense like they had earlier in the first half, they're swinging that ball around. Once they get across the timeline, once they get across the logo, they need to swing the ball around the horn as quickly as possible. It opens things up. They're not doing that lately, and they're getting turnovers.
Gage Ivanov, the inbound the ball. He's out of Alaska. Una Laquite High School. I don't know where Una Laquite is, but that's okay. Castro, Barnes, fumbled it, but enough wherewithal to get it on the glass and good things happen.
It's one basket away from a double-double, Corey.
9 points, 13 rebounds. Levette, he's got 16 points. He leads all scorers in the game. Davis, Richardson, hard worker, and there's a three by Ford. That's a good-looking offensive play. Xavier Ford, in double figures he averages on the season, that's his first bucket of the game, and another lead, the seventh lead change, 8 minutes to play, 50-49. Howard out of Savannah. Ivanov, back to Howard on the right side. Howard, the lefty, gets to the free throw line. The righty, and he's bumped. Are they going to call a continuation, or are they going to say on the ground?
No, I'm going to say continuation if I'm calling it.
Got to be on the ground.
Wow, they're going to call it on the ground. I would have called it a continuation. He didn't take a dribble. He continued with a step, but he never put the ball on the ground and shot the ball. I call it continuation.
Nah, no continuation. Because it wasn't a layup. And there's a foul on Sammy Richardson. Came across the lane, one step, and then he had to turn and shoot. Nah.
Boy, if it's based on it wasn't a layup, there's a lot of non-continuations here on the community college level.
Yeah, those shouldn't be. Pros get paid. They can get that continuation. Here's Mariolas, Ivanov, Howard, Castro, and Edison on the floor. Edison with the left-handed dribble at the left block. Skip pass to Howard. He's at the right block. And he's very aggressive and misses, but he's fouled. Richardson says, my hands are up. Now they're up. As Howard has 2 points, looking for points 3 and 4. The freshman is 6'1". He's from Anaheim. And it looks to be he's amphibious. He's shooting with the left hand. And he misses. The prior shot, he shot with the right hand.
Doesn't matter what hand. Amphibious, okay.
I'm sorry. He's both-handed. 50-49, Cypress down by one.
So that means he's on the swim team, too, if he's amphibious?
That's the right word, right?
Ambidextrous.
No, it's both-handed. And he misses both free throws, see? 50-49.
Glove.
Turnover.
Richardson, UCLA high post, turns, faces for Ford. He pulls up, nice bucket, left it short. Loose ball foul on Howard. That's the team's sixth in this half. 7:24 to play. 50-49 is your score. Riverside has the lead. And they're going to say, where was in the act of shooting?
Great anticipation by Ware. He went to the basket when he knew the shot was going to be missed. He took the rebound, and Ryan, he had his momentum going towards the basket and laid it back up there. A beautiful call by the official down on the floor.
But even more importantly, he doesn't take that power dribble, because what you'll see lately in the game of basketball is guys put it back down on the floor. Number one thing for a post person, or if you're trying to get that rebound, put it right back up. Don't bring it down, because then that just gives the defender an extra opportunity to get a hand on it.
52-49, he hits both free throws. He's had a strong second half. He's had 9 points in this second half to go along with three rebounds. 7:21 to play with Barnes between the legs. Back out to Mariolas, Edison. Castro looking for Ivanov, comes back out to Edison with 15 to shoot. Approaching 7 minutes to play in the game. Cypress College basketball here on SportsnetUSA.net. Sweet spot, sweet it is by Mariolas. He's got 12 points. 52-51 Riverside with the lead. Tigers looking to extend, taking a little bit of the air out of the ball. Vance, Mobley, Davis, there's a screen. Richardson tries to drive left baseline on Castro. Good defense of moving them feet up and down. Here's Howard, he's up lane, and going straight up is Castro. Good defense by Sebastian. 52-51, Cypress can take the lead. You like the defense because he went straight up. He was there in position. He didn't whack at it. There's a back door. Castro underneath. Over two. Can't convert. Ivanov keeps it alive. Motley corrals it. Davis in the front court. 5:55 to play. They finally hit Motley on the slip, and there it is. He came up to set the screen. He didn't set it. He rolls to the basket. That is a pretty play. Justin Motley with his first bucket out of Lutheran East High School in Ohio.
Lutheran?
Lutheran. He goes to Lutheran. Everybody from Orange County goes to Lutheran.
Okay. We want to make sure.
54-51, 5:32 to play. Here's Mariolas. Cypress working on Richardson. Dumps down low. Motley's length. Makes the deflection and the turnover. Here's Davis. Davis in the corner to four. Back to Davis. Davis does a nice job running the point. Richardson. Vance gets a step. He loses the ball. Stolen by Barnes. Barnes and Cypress down by three. In the lane. Over Richardson. No good. Blocked, but they got a foul on the arm. And Cameron Barnes will head back to the line for two shots.
So Cameron Barnes with 14 rebounds and 9 points is 1 point away from having a double-double in this game when you look at him. Leading scorer so far, Levette with 16 for Riverside. Ware follows with 10. Then we go to Walker and Ford. Those are the guys for Riverside. For Cypress, it's Castro, Barnes, and Mariolas. Castro's got 10. Barnes has 9. Mariolas has 8. Edison with 8. Keith Turner has 5. And Cade Flowers have 5 in the game. Like we said, Cameron Barnes, Corey, with 14 rebounds in this game. Impressive game for Barnes tonight for Cypress.
Yeah, he's really keeping him in the ball game due to his hustle. He's not a guy out there who's going to take over the game offensively, but on the boards, offensively and defensively, he's getting those putbacks. He's getting those hot hustle plays. He's creating opportunities for his teammates as when he gets those rebounds and the double teams come, he'll kick out for open shots. You're sitting at 54-51 now. You're down by three, but a much stronger outing than what we saw when we just watched them play Fullerton last Friday.
For a young team in Riverside, a bunch of freshmen, do you like the way they play the game so far, or do you think they've got a great deal of work even though they're 3-0?
I think this is a team that's very talented as a freshman unit. As the season goes along, they're going to be very good. But if this freshman team, and you know it's hard at the community college level to come back when there's offers, but if this freshman team comes back as a whole and gets one more big guy, you're looking at a top 10 team next year in the California Community College Athletic Association. And speaking of the top 10, San Francisco, Fullerton, Santiago, Columbia, and East LA are the top five. Preseason, I don't know, did we already have this conversation or was I talking to myself when I had East LA and Fullerton making the Final Four?
I was going to say, preseason. You do a lot of that, so I don't know.
I had them preseason, and City College of San Francisco were three of the four teams that I had preseason going to the Final Four this year. Barnes connects on the first free throw, so I was talking to myself on that one. Okay.
Did you have Fullerton as good as they are right now at this stage of the season? Yes. Ryan sort of shook his head.
I did after I spoke to DJ Houston.
Okay.
I thought they were going to be very good. They misses the second free throw, so 54-52. I didn't think they would be this good until we talked to DJ Houston after the interview on air. And then I was like, okay, yeah, they're going to be very good, borderline great. And there's Richardson up and under his first bucket of the game, or excuse me, second bucket. He's got 4 points and a four-point lead with 4:43 to play. Here's Mariola's out of the timeout. And we'll see when Tawan Elson can get back for Fullerton. If he gets back semi-healthy, they're going to win a championship this year, back-to-back. Here's Mariola's with 8 seconds, slipped by Castro. Cross-court pass to Slaughter. Back to Edison, wants a three, forces a three. Front rim, but there's Barnes again, 15 rebounds, misses the putback, and the rebound heads out and grabbed by Collins. And here's Collins now in the front court. Left-handed dribble back out to Walker. They don't need to rush. They have 4 minutes to play in a four-point lead. 18 fouls for Riverside, 16 fouls for Cypress. The team's leading scorer has the ball now. He's got 16 points in the game tonight. Little poke out by Barnes. Richardson saves. Three. There's two. Edwin Collins for three. That's off to the right. Coach Al Hadaf wants a timeout, and he gets a timeout near side with 3:32 to play in the game. 56-52 is your score. Tigers up on the Chargers. This is Cypress College basketball on SportsnetUSA.net. Corey, Mark, Ryan, Paul, having fun. Gabby, not so much.
Well, Gabby would probably play defense right now the way Perry Webster teaches that she'd come in here and whack Corey 8 or 9 times across the arm.
Let's put it this way. The look I just got from Gabby, she doesn't need to play defense with her hands or feet. She just stares and says, oh, here, turnover.
But
well,
Ryan,
what? I'll say Coach Alhadis' defense hasn't been doing a lot of staring. When you look at their hands overall, anytime that Riverside comes down the floor, their hands are in the passing lane, and it's forcing Riverside to try and figure out how to get it to other teammates. Now, Mark, you and I, we're both aficionados for the old bounce pass.
Yes.
We haven't necessarily seen that from Riverside City College's offense, and when
we
they have
it
done it,
yeah.
When they have done it, it led to a basket.
Yeah, it was a pretty bounce pass that got there. And so I'm going to ask both of you scheme-wise, not talent-wise, scheme-wise defensively, what does Fullerton offer that we haven't seen from the other community college teams, just scheme-wise defensively?
Just a whole total buy-in.
That's it?
That's it.
You agree with that?
Yeah, absolutely.
I like these engaging conversations that we have about basketball.
Well, what more can you say? If your team doesn't buy in, you can't play defense, and you can't get your scheme to where you want it to be. Perry Webster's teams have bought in significantly and wholeheartedly to the defensive side of the ball. 3:32 out of the timeout. Down by 4, Cypress has it. Mariola, Slaughter, Castro running baseline, Barnes, and Edison. Edison, left-handed three. Back rim, that's the shot they wanted as well. Last touched by, they're going to say, Jalen Slaughter. Coach Alhadaf doesn't like the call.
So Cypress still shooting 38% from the floor, 31% from 3-point, 63% from the free throw line for Riverside, 40 from the floor, 35 from 3, and 78 from the free throw line.
Davis. Levette, moving screen. They're going to say a moving screen on Justin Motley. And so 3:05 to play, down by 4. Chargers with the ball. Moving to the left side of Don Johnson Court. Mariolas keeps the dribble alive, working on Edwin Collins. Barnes pulls up from 17. He's fouled. It looks like he comes down hard on his right ankle. With 2:55 to play, he'll go to the line for two, where tonight, one, two, he's 2 for 3. He's got two more coming. 15 rebounds in the game. 10 points. So Mark, he's got his double-double.
And Corey, he has not committed a foul in tonight's game either. So a young man that's played as hard as he has and has played tough nose-to-nose basketball has done it the proper way and hasn't had a foul called on him in this game so far.
And sophomore from Hesperia connects. So Melvin Walker checks back into the ball game along with Darius Ware. Out goes Richardson and Motley. And this is a game that Cypress needed to play well in, and they're playing well. They're 0-3 to start the conference, Riverside 3-0. Cypress needs this ball game to feel good and move forward for the rest of the season. Here's Edwin Collins, and he dribbles it off his right foot out of bounds. That's an unforced turnover, 2:40 to play, and the Chargers have a chance to tie or take the lead.
And I think Coach Matthews would like to walk away 4-0 with a young team. You can keep your head up and say, hey, we're growing. And at the same time, Corey, not only are we growing, but we continue to win.
Yeah, as Edwin Collins checks out for Xavier Ford. And that's the thing. If you can continue to win while you're still not 100% where you want to be, that just does nothing but help a young group of guys in a tough, tough conference. Here's Edison. He drives. Barnes feeling the 3-0. Nice closeout by Levette. And there's a turnover by Cypress. Barnes got a little bit too active, wanted to be a little bit too creative, and good defense by Levette.
Well, you watch Riverside, they play man-to-man. What they do is they cover when their person's got the ball, but they will help on defense. That team defense attitude is just something that has carried some of the good teams to make them better teams, and the better teams to be state champions.
10 team fouls for Riverside, 16 fouls for Cypress, 2:13 to play in the game, and a 2-point lead for the Tigers. Dumps down low, poked away, and saved by Barnes. Barnes makes up for his turnover. Now charges in the forecourt. Weave to Edison, Mariolas. Mariolas is hot in the first half, not hot in the second half. He's due, and here's Slaughter running baseline. Castro, one-on-one against Davis, clears that side of the court. Just outstanding defense by the Tigers. And here's Walker the other way. Castro, they cleared out one side of the court for him, and he dribbles to the middle where the defense is located and gets the ball stolen, and a timeout taken by the Tigers with 1:36 to play. They're up 56-54. This is Cypress College Basketball on SportsnetUSA.net.
Well, don't forget before we walk away today, if you're having problems with your car and you need a new one, well, Miller Toyota of Anaheim. You've got that Toyota that you just need tuned up. Well, maybe you need to get your car smogged and that engine light comes up and you've got to get it smogged. You take it into Miller Toyota. They get that engine light for you and they'll smog your car. Or maybe you just have nothing to do and say, hey, I want to go window shopping. Go to Miller Toyota of Anaheim, located at Euclid and the 91 in Anaheim. Miller Toyota of Anaheim has been a proud sponsor of community college sports, high school sports, but most of all, education. So next time you're out there, check out Miller Toyota of Anaheim, located at Euclid and the 91.
Riverside came into this game averaging 83 points per game in conference. Cypress 46.3. Cypress is playing better. Riverside, you know, I'm not going to say they're playing worse, but the defense for Cypress has really stepped up and made them work for these 56 points. We gave you the top five earlier in the CCC MBCA poll. Other OEC teams in the top 30. And you have to look at Saddleback at 21. Irvine Valley at 24, the only others OEC teams in the top 30.
Ryan, when you get a second, tell us who else is winning out there.
1:36 to play, 2-point lead for the Tigers and the ball. Walker, Levette, top of the key, thought about that three, pounded by Slaughter, up with the left hand, no good. Barnes has it go off his fingertips, controlled by Edison. Edison with 118, and Mariolas in the front court. stacked high. Barnes, corner. Edison, open three. Blocked again up top. That's the second by Davis. And Davis and Riverside in the front court, under a minute to play. Great block by Davis. That's two on that side of the floor. 3-point shots that he's blocked, and Walker working one-on-one. Mariola's defending. Castro picks up high. Davis drives into corner. He likes that spot. Don't he, though? Xavier Ford got 6 points, two threes from the left corner. And that, with 38 seconds to play, puts Riverside up 59-54, and a big, big three.
Well, Corey, when you look at SportsnetUSA.net and one of the teams that you had in your Final Four, East LA, they end up winning tonight 86-72. That was here on SportsnetUSA.net. Dan Godino on the call there. They beat LA Southwest once again by 14. Another team that you mentioned just a few moments ago, Saddleback, who is in the top 30, 93-52 win over top of Orange Coast. They now improved to 10-6 this year. LA Valley is now going to drop to 12-3 as they end up losing to 9-6 Citrus, 74-64, a 10-point loss.
LA Valley is ranked number 15 coming into this week, and Citrus having a down year, not ranked at all in the top 30.
Compton and LA Trade Tech, 125-96.
Who won that one?
That was LA Trade Tech with a victory.
Oh, wow, because Compton is usually the one with the 125-point outing. LA Trade Tech, they're not a top 30 team. And neither is Compton this year.
Rounding out the other two, West Hills Coalinga ends up losing it to Sequoias, who now moves up to 12-3, and Ventura, 105. Santa Barbara, 51. So Ventura moves up to 10-7.
College of the Sequoias is number 8 in the state during this week. So out of the timeout, down by 5 with the ball, the Chargers. Castro to inbound, Mariolas. Slaughter, Barnes, and Edison. They need a quick shot, doesn't have to be a 3. Barnes on the right side. He drives, puts it up, no good, but you got to make the 2. Down low, fighting, battling, jump ball, Richardson, Barnes. Possession arrow stays with the Chargers. 25 seconds remaining. Now you need a 3.
Yeah, like you said, if Barnes goes strong to the basket, Corey, and tries to finish it as we get a 30-second timeout with 25 seconds to go. I'm going to take you back to that play because you talked about you've talked about it for all the years we've done community college basketball, be it men or women. Some of the basic fundamentals of the game just seem to fade away on this level. And it used to be at one time community college basketball had some big names in it that moved on. It just seems, I don't know if it's strictly because of the way basketball plays out now with one and done?
Not strictly, no.
No?
No. There's a lot to do with the educational aspect. You remember the Prop 48 rule, mm-hmm. where if you don't qualify academically, you got to sit out a year.
Yeah.
And you can't play. So those Prop 48 players, a lot of those enhanced community college. After the heyday, community college for all sports, 50s, 60s, even the 70s, for the heyday of community college sports. But with those academic rule changes, the Prop 48 allowed that to continue to grow and keep community college or keep college basketball players and other players at this level. Now you don't have that anymore. Now you have AAU. Now you have one and done. Now you have laxed academic procedures that allow students to get in there and perform at a high level. Now you have more schools building up, like Bethesda University and all those popping up. Takes away from community college athletics, all that builds into this. Castro to inbound, and there is a timeout or a foul. It's going to call a hold on Xavier Ford, and that should be 2 free throws. Ball hadn't been inbounded yet. So you get 2 free throws and no time off the clock. And the problem with all that is that the talent level is not the same. But the product of the game is not bad. Product of the game is what you want to see. Yeah, I come out to watch a community college basketball game. I'll do that more now that I live closer to a community college. I'll do that more because it's still quality basketball. And you still have people competing. And Jalen Slaughter hits two free throws and cuts the lead to three with 25.4 seconds to play.
And let's be honest, the price is usually right to come watch these young men and young women play the game of basketball.
Yeah, because they want to get to the next level like everybody wants to get to a next level. And Lavette on the inbound. And last touch out of bounds by Lavette on the double team, 22.2 to play. And you realize you didn't have to foul on that aspect because you have 10 seconds to get the ball over half court. So you don't foul right away as Lavette checks out of the ball game and timeout taken. That's going to be a timeout taken by Cypress. 22.2 seconds, down by three. You don't need a three, but you can get a quick two. And the reason why the Riverside coaches are not happy is because when you get in that situation to beat that zone, you have to face up, survey the floor in all but 1 but 2 seconds and get the ball and move the ball out of your hands and don't get trapped.
Well, and let's give it to Gage Ivanov, Corey. He reaches down, slaps the basketball, makes sure he gets all ball, no hands, so the officials don't even give you a iffy call on the play. And so give it to Ivanov. Give him a lot of credit for making the play that he made for that Cypress team.
And I like the play they're drawing up in the huddle on the Tigers sideline.
So you go out that way, you go out that way, you go this way. Hey, Corey, give the ball up. Ryan will be open. You know what the answer to that is? I'm taking the three. Corey Neyland needs to be here.
Like I said, the level of competition and the level of play gauges if I'm a pass or not.
Wow, Ryan.
What I saw from that play was three different guys, all three of us, make it four of us here in the booth, driving out to Miller Toyota of Anaheim to check out some newer used vehicles.
There we go.
You see all three players setting the screen, one, two, three. Castro inbounds to Edison, takes a three, but he's on the line, connects on a two. 59, 50, we don't have it yet. They say it's going to be a three over the front court. They say it's a three, so 59-59. 9 seconds remaining, no timeouts. Walker with the ball against Mariolas in the corner. Open, Collins blocked and fouled. Castro got him on the arm. He got ball, but he got him on the arm, and that'll send Edwin Collins to the line for two shots. So 59-59 is your score. Edwin Collins at the line. 4-2, he needs one. 6'3 freshman from JW North. And he makes the first free throw with 2.6 seconds remaining. And it is 60-59, timeout Tigers. One more coming after the break.
Well, Ryan, I tell you what, if the squeeze is this hard on you and you're buying a new car, there's no better place to go than Miller Toyota of Anaheim. I tell you what, maybe all four tires are empty and you've only got one spare in your trunk, where would you go? Miller Toyota of Anaheim. One other thing you got to look at, if you had to drive 60 miles and you only had 59 minutes, well, don't ride with Corey Neyland because he doesn't have a brand new car from Miller Toyota of Anaheim. Ride with Ryan Osborn because he'll get you there in style and in comfort because of that new Toyota from Miller Toyota of Anaheim. That's right. There's only one place to go in Orange County to get the best buy, the best deal, the best car, the best Toyota you're looking for. Euclid in the 91, that's Miller Toyota of Anaheim, a proud sponsor of community college sports, high school sports, and most of all, education. That's Miller Toyota of Anaheim.
So Edwin Collins connected on the first free throw with 2.6 seconds to play in the game. Second free throw is in, 61-60 in a full court press. Castro can run the baseline. Here's Edison with two. Up, it'll count if it goes. It does not go, and that's the ball game, folks. What a game as Riverside pulls it out 61 to 59, and they improve their record to 9-7, 4-0 in conference as Cypress drops to 9-7, 0-4 in conference. Quickly before we get out of here, guys. Nope. So for Paul Array, Ryan Osborn, Mark Pavlovich.
Wait a minute. I was going to say let go. I've been your partner for how many years?
Sorry.
My name has changed.
Sorry, Mike. Mike Pavlovich and Mark Pavlovich. I'm Corey Neyland. Your final once again from Don Johnson Court. Riverside 61, Cypress 59. This has been Cypress College Basketball on SportsnetUSA.net.